If you've just listened to that, rewind that and listen to that again. Purpose. You talk a lot about purpose. Where's the best place to start to help someone really identify and connect with, why am I here? Is there greater meaning than just my current existence?
Well, every individual, regardless of gender, age, or culture, lives moment by moment with a set of priorities or values, things that are most important to least important in their life. I have a high value in research and teaching, traveling. I have a low value in cooking and driving. I haven't cooked since I was 24 and haven't driven in 29 and a half years.
Yeah, right.
So I learned a long time ago, don't do low priority things or you'll devalue yourself. Stick to the things that are most inspiring if you want an inspiring life and delegate the rest, which gives you the accountability of going out and doing something that serves people to earn the income to delegate.
If you've just listened to that, rewind that and listen to that again. Sorry, keep going.
If you're not filling your day with the highest priority actions that really call you, inspire you, your life is going to fill up with low priority distractions as a feedback mechanism to self-depreciate you, to associate pain with things that aren't important to you, to try to guide you back to what is. So self-depreciation and negative thoughts and fears and things are not enemies. They're feedback mechanisms guiding us to what's true for us. So whatever's highest on our value, we're spontaneously inspired from within. That's our calling. Our highest value is our purpose. Our purpose is the most effective and efficient pathway to fulfill the greatest amount of voids with the greatest amount of values. And the voids are all the disowned parts because of our prides and shames and judgments of the past that are stored in the subconscious mind that are trying to vie for attention with our intuition back into our purpose. So the second we live by our highest value, we automatically have the calling, the metier, the primary objective, the end in mind, the most meaningful pursuit, most inspiring pursuit we have. And we don't need motivation again. I don't need motivation to get up and do research and teach and do what I love doing. I'm not a motivational speaker. You're not a motivational speaker. Motivational speaker uses rhetorical persuasion to get people to do things with pleasures and pain stacking to get them to do something they don't want to do, to try to sell what they want to sell. A real inspiring teacher, in my opinion, is somebody who is helping people access their own highest values so they can set sail as captain of their ship and master their fate according to their own calling to make a real difference, because you can't make a difference subordinating and living in the shadows of other people in conformity. You can only do it by standing strong, independent, and creating an original idea that serves people by being original in your thinking. And that comes from living authentically according to your own unique values that are fingerprint specific.
Hey! Let's go.